We must tie Andreas up as soon as possible, otherwise he'll attack us.
You won't be able to prove a thing!
We need to scour this room for any evidence that can prove Andreas faked the prophecy. Andreas has charmed the mirror, using forbidden black magic to make Richard quarrel with his own son. It turns out that if Rald hadn't been banished, he would have gone against his father and killed him. Andreas never intended for Rald to actually become king. He soaked the crown with a poison. As soon as Rald puts the crown on his head, he'll drop dead.
Ha ha! The coronation has already started, and soon the new king will be dead. You won't prove a thing.
Oh, get to the main hall and stop the coronation. In the meantime, I'll be holding Andreas back. I won't let him escape.
Thank you. time to begin the coronation. I'll officiate.
Blasted traitor! You'll pay for that!
Stop, all of you. I've just escaped from the dungeon where Roald was keeping me, but I'm here to defend my son.
Father, I only kept you imprisoned to make everybody think you were dead. I couldn't bring myself to kill you. Why are you standing up for me now?
You can't imagine how much I regret everything I've done to you. Banishing you was the biggest mistake of my life. I'm so sorry.
I forgive you, Father.
Oh, Roald, your father only banished you because his magic mirror told him that you would betray him. Oh, but that prophecy was faked. Andreas did it to get rid of the royal family and take the throne for himself. Ah, who knows what would have happened if the king hadn't summoned you.
I am eternally grateful to you. The entire kingdom owes you a great debt. As for Andreas, he'll rot in a prison cell.